Well, how's it going, everybody? Welcome back to Let's Play Fallout 3, and welcome to the Sniper Rifle episode. This one's called that because we're going to be getting the Reservist Rifle, which is one of the two unique Sniper Rifles in Fallout 3. I've mentioned I want to use it as my main weapon, and I figured why not go out and get one of the two unique ones. I think the Reservist is better than... what's the other one called? I think it's the Victory Rifle. I think it's overall better. I can read you guys the stats later on. But yeah, unfortunately I wasn't able to record what I just did. But basically, to get this Reservist Rifle, you need to go to right here. I forget what the place is called, but it's a chapel. And so I traveled back to Mason-Dixon Salvage, and as soon as I spawned, there was like freaking 6 giant super mutants, like masters and stuff, all around me. Like 2 centaurs and a Yao Guai. It was a crazy fight. Unfortunately, I wasn't recording, but yeah, I killed all these guys and it was pretty tough, and it cost me around like 10 stim packs. Also, we have somebody over here, a wasteland captive. You cannot help the captive while in combat, and I think it's telling me that because there looks like there's one more enemy over here. Let's see what it is. Looks like a rad ant. No, stop. A giant soldier ant. Alright, let's see. That's what I was hoping for. A one-shot kill with the base sniper rifle. Okay, now we should be able to rescue this captive. I think the only thing that gives you is positive karma. Let's go ahead and see. The super mutants have bound the captive for transportation. The ropes are digging into her wrist. She's obviously suffered from their abuse. Leave the captive to her fate. Untie her.
What? Who? You mean... are you for real? I'm safe? I need to get out of here. Here, take these supplies. It's all I have, but they'll only slow me down.
No, you need it more than I will.
You're right. It's dangerous out here. I have to go before more of them come.
God, Jack is such a nice guy, isn't he? Oh, and we've also leveled up. Isn't that wonderful? Okay. So, I think we're putting science to 100. There we go. We have 9 more skill points. What's next? Speech would be good. Repair would also be good. Melee weapons, no. Medicine, no. Explosives, no. Energy weapons, no. Big guns, no. Barter, no. So it's between speech and repair. Speech is definitely more important, so we'll max speech next. Okay, we also have another perk. Let's see if we have any new ones. Tag. Light step. Let's see. It's the same stuff as the last one. I'm thinking tag. I don't know. I don't think tag is good because we're going to end up maxing all of the skills that we want to anyways. I kind of like animal friend even though it's not that important. Let's see. Child at heart would be kind of good. Little eager lady killer. Let's go with intense training again. I don't like picking that because it's like the most boring option, but it's also good. Okay, charisma or endurance or perception. Let's put in perception up to 8. And I think that's the last time we'll do the intense training option. Okay, so I don't think there's anything left here, but just for completion's sake, let's head into the abandoned shack. And I saw there was another door over there just to see if there's anything interesting in this location. Fallout 3, to be quite honest, I never really explored a lot. I just stuck to the main quest, the side quests, and pretty much all the miscellaneous quests and different things that you could do. I never really like explored the different locations, which is why I kind of want to start the Fallout 3's Hidden Treasures series soon, because I haven't seen a lot of these places. Okay, 308 is exactly what I want. We're going to be getting more 308 rounds later in this episode. My voice definitely didn't crack there. You just made that up. Okay, I think that's it. Although, I just want to make sure we're not missing any, like, bobblehead. I'm pretty sure we're not going to miss any bobbleheads because I probably remember the names of where they're located since I have gotten all of them like a couple times in different playthroughs. Okay, I was like, where's that radio coming from? Alright, there's another abandoned shack over here. So we'll just check this really quick and then we'll go and get the Reservist Rifle. Okay, let's see. It doesn't look like there's anything in here that's unique, which is kind of surprising, honestly. Usually there is. There's an empty footlocker, some caps on top of it. There is an ammo crate. I do see a skill book, which is what? Nikola Tesla and you. I believe that's science. Blood pack, body pin, and stim packs are exactly what we want. Let's go ahead and read that. Actually, no. Big book of science is science, so this should be energy weapons. Yes. Okay. Good, because we already have 100 science anyways. And by the way, since we have 100 science now, we can hack any terminal. Since we have 100 lockpick, we can lockpick any lock. And I believe that's pretty much it. So now we're pretty primed for doing the Fallout 3 Hidden Treasure series. But it's only if you guys really, you know, I'm going to test the waters by making a couple episodes. I'm not sure how popular it will be considering this game is pretty damn old. Okay, we have a person over here. It looks like the person we just freed, Wasteland Captive. Yeah, and we also have people that are chasing her. Dogs. We're going to leave her to her fate because I don't want to waste any ammo. Yeah, that's the way the wasteland goes. Okay, ow! I was like, what the hell? Dogs can't throw grenades. Okay, looks like we also have a raider here. Let's shoot him once in the face and shoot the dog once in the face. Kaboom! And also, by the way, even though a sniper rifle is a huge gun, it is classified as a small gun, which is great because we have 100 small guns. So, that's why we do so much damn damage there. It's kind of disappointing, though, that there's only two unique sniper rifles in the whole game. Like I said, the one that we're about to get, and the victory rifle. The victory rifle, I forget what the thing is about it, but I'll find it out and read it to you guys in a second here. Okay, so this should be where we want to go, I think, although it doesn't look like a chapel. Whoa, okay, what the hell was that? Looks like something just fired a nuke at this or something. Oh, I think there are, like, nuke-related things over here. Let's see what this place is called. WKML Broadcast Station, and we're getting rads. Alright, let's see. It might be that little triangle in the distance there. You can see I put, like, a map marker sort of somewhere around here. I'm not sure exactly where this is, however. Do you guys see a chapel over there? Well, why don't I just figure it out, and then I'll see you guys there. Alright, so I do see the chapel in the distance there, as well as a dog here, and I'll just read you guys what this says. So the victory rifle has identical damage to the sniper rifle. The victory rifle has triple the item HP, though, so it doesn't have to be repaired nearly as often. And it knocks down targets with critical hits. However, on the offside, it pays for this ability with a reduced critical chance of 3. So less critical hits, but when you do critically hit, it knocks people down. Kind of like the Gauss rifle on every shot, which is kind of OP. In comparison, the reservist rifle has 50% more durability, so it also has increased durability. What the hell is that noise? I have no idea. Let's see. It also has a slightly higher rate of fire, but less magazine capacity. It has 3 rounds instead of 5 in each magazine and costs 6 AP less to shoot in VATS. And it looks like that's it. So this does seem like the better option here. And it looks like, I didn't see if this was where we wanted to go. Let's just double check. Dickerson Tabernacle Chapel. Yeah, that's exactly what we want. And I don't know if I've ever gotten the sniper rifle before. I know I use sniper rifles heavily, but I might have only used like the base one, not the unique one, which is kind of sad. Alright, let's go ahead and loot all this. Hopefully we'll get some 308 for our newly acquired sniper rifle, which should be upstairs. There should be like a ladder or something leading up. There's 12 308 rounds, which is great. Let's see, we got a couple more ammunition boxes here. Don't need the shotgun shells so much, but it would be nice to find a unique shotgun as well. Okay, so let's see, is that the Drifter? It is, and he's also... yeah, a red blip. Okay, so that's a unique type of enemy that has a reservist rifle, and you can see he's sort of held up there, and he's just, like, taking pot shots at people. So let's get a good shot at him. We're still in sneak mode, so we'll probably kill him in one shot, I would guess. Okay, alright. Well, actually, you just moved to a better vantage point for me. Thank you. Let's take a good look at him. He looks like he's got an eye patch. Alright. So. Damn it, I was afraid of that. Yeah, the wooden beam is blocking his face, and now he's basically just going to be alerted. Okay. Sniper battle. And there's the sniper rifle just dropped right in front of us, the reservist rifle. Alright, so let's take a look at it. Let's also drop this Mutafruit. Okay, let's repair this. Let's repair this. Looks like we can't. Let's drop those then. Oh, crap. I didn't try to repair old painless. Okay, anyways. Reservist rifle. The damage is the exact same, but like I said, it has 50% more durability, and it also fires faster. So we'll go ahead and put that up there. And can we repair it with the sniper rifle? Yes, cool. Alright, so we got ourselves a unique sniper rifle. I'm pretty sure it's going to look exactly the same. That's one thing I'm kind of disappointed with, is that in Fallout 3, usually the unique weapons look exactly the same, which is kind of disappointing. It looks like there's not a way to loot the Drifter's body. Is he still up there, or did he fall down? It looks like he's still up there, and I don't think... yeah, I don't think there's any way to get up there. Let's just take a quick look around. I don't think he has anything else that's unique anyways. Yeah, obviously if you were on the PC, you could do the console magic to do it, but we're not on the PC, so unfortunately we're going to have to leave the Drifter there, but like I said, I don't think he has anything unique. Okay, so now the next part of the Sniper Rifle episode is to go to Minefield, which we were, like, recently, I think, maybe the last episode, and Arkansas is still alive. Because we didn't, remember, we made a new save file, and then we did the Paradise Falls quest. So, we didn't kill Arkansas, but hopefully we're going to sneak behind him and loot all of his 308 ammo. Alright, so here we are once again in Minefield. Now, what's funny is that, like I said in the last episode, he always shoots at us, regardless of if we're in sneak or not. So, we should be able to see him in the distance there. Now, you can kill Arkansas. He's a red blip, which means you're not going to lose any karma, and, you know, he's trying to kill you anyways. But there's something comforting about walking through Minefield and having this guy always here shooting at you. You know, it adds to the ambiance of the game. You know what I mean? So we're going to leave him alive, and we're hopefully going to sneak behind him and grab all of his ammo instead. It's just simply because 308 ammo is pretty hard to come by, and the more you can find, the better. Oh, wow, I did it again. Two freaking episodes in a row. How did I not activate these the first time around? Oh, wait, no, I don't think we ever came up here because we were doing the Wasteland Survival Quest. Alright, up we go. There's Arkansas right there. He's actually looking at me. That's pretty creepy, although he doesn't see me. Could you see this? I'm pretty sure anybody could see this. Alright, so we're going to sneak up right behind him and open these ammo boxes, which are easy, but we only have 4 lockpicks. Oh god, please don't break on an easy lock. Really? Then where is it? There we go. Okay, 32 caliber, that's not that great. I'm looking for 308, there's 6, that's okay. And let's see, 308, another 6, so that's 12. And finally, 44 Magnum. Alright, so let's go ahead and also pickpocket Arkansas and see what he has. Ridgefield gate key and 308 caliber rounds, both of which I want. Let's save the game. And let's pickpocket him and hopefully grab both of these.
You stole that!
No, I didn't. He said you stole that and he doesn't even know who's here. Alright, let's reload that and try that once more. I wonder what the Ridgefield key is. I literally have no clue what that leads to. Really? Okay, I'm gonna keep hacking away at this. Alright, there we go. Only took the next try. We're gonna go ahead and leave the 32 caliber, or the 308 rounds, because it's only 2 and we have, let's see, 36 so far, which is pretty good. Can we save? Nope. No! Keep forgetting to look for these damn mines. Alright, there's one more over here by the mailbox. And looks like that's it. Can we wait now? Oh, jeez. There we go. Okay, well, I think that's it for the sniper rifle centered content in this episode. Can we wait again? Yeah. Let's see what to do. Well, we still have Picking Up the Trail, Enter Vault 87, but the thing is, we still are not able to do Trouble on the Home Front. Let me try one more time, ladies and gentlemen. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, so I did a little bit of research, and apparently we can't do Trouble on the Home Front because I killed the freaking Overseer. I think I did. I'm forgetting if I did or not, since that was quite a while ago. But I'm pretty sure I did, and apparently if you do that, you can't do the Trouble on the Home Front quest. So we might not be able to show it on this Let's Play. I might check one last possible time, but I'm pretty sure we can't do it. So anyways, I headed back to Lamplight Caverns, and that's this right here. We still haven't been inside and seen it, so that's what we're going to do in this episode. And I think we'll finish this main quest, and then we might do something else after that. So, Lamplight Office Building, I don't think that's important. We'll just head into the main Lamplight. You guys can see what it is. It's pretty cool. Pretty cool indeed, and it's run entirely by kids, which is kind of interesting. Alright, so as you would expect, it's a cavern, so there's going to be, yeah, it says Spelunkers and Great Chamber. Yeah, so that's what we're looking for. And food, and it's called, this place is called food because what they do is they forage, like, mushrooms from the water, and they eat it, and it's gross. Where does this lead? Let's see. The Great Chamber, yeah, so that's, we could probably go through there, but we're just gonna follow our map marker for now. I don't think we can loot this, right? Oh, we can, okay. Let's see, 5mm and 10mm and 5.56. Now, you can't kill any of these kids. This is a, this game rated mature? I think it's rated mature, but yeah, you can't kill any of these kids even if you fire at them. They'll just run away. So we're going to go ahead and follow our map marker. We're trying to find the entrance to Vault 87 because there's a Gek inside and we need a Gek to get Project Purity back online. Okay, so where is this leading us? Let's see. Looks like back here. Let's follow this for now. Okay, there's a dog named Rex. Hello there. And looks like we have another entrance or exit. Let's see. I wonder, can we just activate it? I know this is the thing to activate it, or... What the hell do we need to do here? I thought you activate the stones and it does that. This thing always confuses me. Like, I always get confused at this part because I forget what I have to do. Let's talk to Sammy.
We didn't need any Mungo's help getting out of there, you know. But you did it. So, thanks.
Yeah, no problem.
But that means I gotta go back to guarding the back gate with Princess. Ugh.
I really need to get to Vault 87. Do you know the way?
We don't go there. It's bad back there. Ask Mayor if you really want to know.
Pretty sure I already asked the Mayor. Do you enjoy guarding the gate? Of course not. Can you give me directions? Blah, 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 blah. Okay, that's enough. I have to go now. There's Princess. I think you do have to talk to Princess.
What the hell is RJ thinking? Letting a damn Mungo like you in here. So who are you working with? Raiders? Slavers? Mutants? Answer up, Mungo!
The mayor let me in because I rescued some of your friends.
Oh, you think Sammy and the rest wouldn't have gotten back on their own eventually? I taught them better than that. Well, if you're sticking around, you ought to know that I'm Princess and I call the shots around here. And don't forget it, Mungo!
Okay, well, what's like guarding the back gate?
It's so dumb. I wish I was at... Which...
Why would you have shot at me? Yeah, okay. How did someone like you get the nickname Princess? Can you give me directions? No scram, I have to go now. Yeah, this part always confuses me because you're supposed to get past this gate and I don't know how the hell you're supposed to open it. Can't activate these rocks. Can't activate those rocks. Can't just walk up to the gate and activate this. Can't jump over it, I don't think, because there's stalactites and stuff all over it. I guess I just have to figure out what the hell I'm supposed to do here. So the problem was we need to talk to Mayor MacCready before we can do either of the two options. You can go through Murder Pass or you can go through a backdoor option, which leads you to the same place.
Okay, so you get in, but I got my eye on you. You don't make any trouble in here, got it? I ain't having no shit butts making trouble.
Shit butts, huh? I'm not planning on starting any trouble.
Good. Better stay that way, Mungo.
Okay, I really need to get to Vault 87. Do you know the way?
It's not safe, even for someone as brave as you. There's monsters back there.
Monsters, what monsters, but those are super mutants, so you know the way to get there?
Yeah, I do. It's through Murder Pass. Not a real safe way to go, but it's the only door that works.
That's the only way?
It's the only way that works, yeah. The other door hasn't worked since before I was here. Computer's busted, and not even Joseph can make it work.
Where can I find Joseph?
I'm the mayor, not a babysitter, Mungo. Beats me. Maybe he's back there by the door. Fuck if I know.
Okay, let's see. Alright, so we're not going to use Murder Pass. We're going to try and find Joseph. This is one of the most annoying parts about Fallout 3. Every time I get here, I cannot find this little shit anywhere. But yeah, Joseph will allow us to enter through the back door. Oh, that sounds dirty, but he will. And we can, I think, from what I remember, it doesn't, like, really help you out all that much. It just gives you, like, supplies or something. You still have to travel the same exact way, I think. But I think Joseph is also usually in the Great Chamber. So before we end this episode, we'll try and find him. Here's the Great Chamber. And you guys are about to see why it's called the Great Chamber. Okay. Alright, so is that Joseph? No. Oh, I hate how they always run around, but usually the ones that are running are just unnamed people. Okay, so this is the Great Chamber we're about to see in a second here. We need to find Joseph, who has some sort of computer skills, I guess. And, yeah, alright, so, let's see. Let's see if we can spot him here. Does VATS work? No, it doesn't work. Alright, Joseph, so we're basically just looking for little blue blips and trying to see. I think he's, like, black or something. He's either, like, black or Hispanic, if I remember right. That might be him down... No, that's a girl. I saw somebody, though. Oh, that might... Yeah, actually, that might be him right there. Let's drop down here and jump out.
Watch it.
No, that's Penny. Damn it. You look like a boy. All right, what about
Watch
you?
It.
No. Okay, yeah, so this is so weird. It's like just a bunch of little kids running around a giant cavern. All right. Well, I'll just go ahead and try and locate him. Unless he's right here. No, that's a dog. Alright, so I didn't find Joseph, but I did find Billy, and just really quickly, we're going to go ahead and save. This guy actually has a unique weapon, and I'm just going to show you guys this before we end this episode here, and I'll find Joseph
Hello,
in the next
mister.
Episode. His name's Billy because he always talks like a little kid. Maybe I'll regret this, but no. Let's see. You said you were selling your Wazer rifle?
I sure did. 500 caps, and this laser rifle's all yours.
Okay, 500 caps for a laser rifle. I almost talk like him. Laser rifle, all right, it's a deal, kid.
Thanks a lot. Bye now.
Goodbye. All right, so 500 caps removed. Let's take a look at this thing here. So, laser rifle is actually what it's called. Let me do a quick search to see how it differs from a normal laser rifle. Laser rifle. Okay, let's see. While identical in appearance to the laser rifle, it does 5 more damage and also comes equipped with a larger magazine with 30 shots instead of the standard 24. It also is 80% more durable. So there you go. It's a lot better than the standard laser rifle. Come back here, Billy! Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to end this episode here. Don't worry, I'm going to reload that save. We're not going to anger all the little lamplight kids. And in the next episode, we will attempt to go into Murder Pass. I don't know if we're going to actually be going into Murder Pass or if we're going to be circumventing it. Either way, we're going to find our way to Vault 87 and try and locate the Geck. Thanks for watching this episode, ladies and gentlemen. I do hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, please remember to like and share the video wherever you can. It really helps me out. If you have a question or a suggestion, Twitter is the best way to get in touch with me, and if you'd like to subscribe or watch another video that's going to be related to this one, you can click the annotations on the screen. Thanks again, and I'll see you in the next one.